I'm Brian McNulty, SCADA Division Manager and Engineer with OS Engineering.
I'm Jeremy Browning, Controls Manager and Engineer with OS Engineering.
OS Engineering, the engineering branch of Olson Industrial Electric, is a premier ignition integrator that provides a wide range of electrical and automation services throughout various industries, including electric and water utilities, as well as manufacturing. Based in Springfield, Oregon, we support the design, construction, and integration of power and control systems. Our staff of licensed engineers and seasoned control system integrators serve a wide range of clients. Northern Wasco County PUD serves the Dalles and surrounding areas of Wasco County, Oregon. They supply power to over 25,000 people across an 87 square mile coverage area. Northern Wasco County PUD approached OS Engineering to develop a fully connected monitoring application to track all intelligent electronic devices, or IEDs, at 9 substations and key field reclosers. These IEDs included protection relays for transformers, feeder breakers, voltage regulators, reclosers, and power quality monitors. Initially, the 9 substations and field reclosers did not have connectivity back to the central office where the ignition server was located. Northern Wasco County PUD worked with TossieBox in the early stages of the project to implement a fully connected SCADA network across all sites using the TossieBox Virtual Central Lock and the TossieBox 670 lock solutions. This network infrastructure provided cellular connectivity to the rural substations, allowing ignition to see all the IEDs. Once the TossieBox network infrastructure was implemented, OS Engineering began development of the substation monitoring application. Starting with the IED configuration and data mapping to SEL real-time automation controllers, or RTACs, located at each substation, Ignition would be able to communicate with all IEDs using the DNP3 driver. UDTs were defined for all devices and paired with a set of standard templates, faceplates, and windows for each object type that were developed using ISA 101 standards for high-performance HMI. We put a modern spin on the UI, making it approachable and intuitive for operators to use. All substation screens were built out with dashboards for key substation parameters, as well as one-line diagrams, coverage area maps, and RTAC and IED dashboards for status and monitoring. Each IED has a corresponding faceplate for additional status for the over 23,000 tags monitored within the application. We also developed a custom flagging system that allows operators to place informational flags on equipment, flagging them for maintenance and other purposes. These tags are visible on the corresponding device within the one line, with full history available on the object's faceplate. The full system development, from the configuration of SEL RTACs and IEDs for data mapping to the commissioning of the system, was completed remotely thanks in large part to the TossieBox network infrastructure.
The SCADA system home screen begins with the system overview. This screen provides real-time status information for all of the Northern Wasco County PUD substations. This screen shows a detailed map of the various symbols showing substation locations, GeoJSON boundaries representing areas supplied by specific feeders, any active alarms with their location, and current power demand data along with historical peaks. Clicking on a substation marker will allow users to drill down into that specific substation to view more detailed information about that site. Users may also select a substation from the left-hand navigational menu. By selecting the expand icon at the top right of the system load container, it will launch the full view of the various substations and the real-time load information. This view also provides connection status of the IEDs located at each site and a 24-hour demand trend. The metering screen presents real-time total and diversified load along with the 7-day and 12-month historical demand and energy data provide a detailed glimpse into the load on the grid. Historical peak demand and energy usage is also stored in a SQL database as to provide a comparison tool for long-term power budgeting and load balancing. A dropdown on the right-hand side allows for the separation of diversified data from total load data. The substation overview screen provides a simple one line of the substation while indicating essential recloser, feeder, and transformer statuses, feeder loading, and demand data. All substations have a similar format for their screens, including an overview that displays a simplified one line diagram with essential equipment, 24-hour trends, load balance chart, and equipment snapshot containers, along with navigational tabs. The map view shows various service areas and loading for each feeder, a metering view that shows historical energy usage, and the diagnostics view that highlights IED connection status to the substation's RTAC. To obtain more detailed information about a specific IED, a user can right-click the component on the overview's one-line diagram and selecting pin device details. This provides a quick look of the device to include significant statuses and loading information. To gain a full summary of the device, a user may left-click on the equipment icon to view discrete and analog values, controls, the tagging interface, 24-hour trends, an active alarm status table, and display property setting. To create a hold or informational flag on a specific piece of equipment, a user with approved security roles can simply select a tag type, enter a reason, and then click Add Tag. Tag creation and modification data is stored in a SQL database for auditing purposes. Only an administrator or the person who created the tag may remove it. The Map View tab provides a zoomed-in look at the areas within the DALs that each feeder is supplying, along with the total customer served. Anytime a feeder is faulted or opens, the overlay for that area will turn red to indicate that the area is no longer being supplied with electricity. The Substation Metering tab shows up much like the System Metering screen, however this screen breaks down the historical demand and energy use by power banks and feeders within a specific substation, therefore providing more granular analysis of a substation's performance. Real-time loading per feeder is also displayed at the top to assist operators in load balancing. The Substation Diagnostics tab is used to view the general condition of the substation RTAC and the associated IEDs that are connected to it. This helps to quickly identify network status and if there are problems with the RTAC's interface with ignition or the IEDs with the RTAC. Clicking on an IED within the connected devices table will also show all significant metering values, statuses, and controls for that piece of equipment. There are a variety of reporting features used in this project. These include reliability metrics, historical demand peaks, outage information, and diversified versus total system load. Throughout the project, users have many options to view embedded trends, but there are a few ways that more powerful trending tools can be applied. One way to launch these trending features is to click on the trend icon on the system overview screen on the right-hand side. This will launch the ad hoc trending screen while loading a pre-made trend featuring values such as power, power factor, and voltage. On the screen, users have full control to change time frame, scaling, add and remove tag pins, change colors, and save trends for further viewing. Trends may be saved for public viewing or private viewing for the current user only.
The substation monitoring project brought new real-time visibility to Northern Wasco County PUD's electric transmission and distribution infrastructure. Outages and other system statuses can now be identified easily using the application and enunciated to operation through email and SMS alarms. The influx of available data has also made automated reports possible. Ignition's DNP3 driver allowed for event-based polling of end devices, reducing data usage at remote sites. It also allowed for easy SEL RTAC controller integration to consolidate IED data at each site with a reliable connection that includes event buffering. Additionally, as OS Engineering designed the project to make full use of Ignition's UDT and template capabilities, additional devices can be added to the system with ease using a full complement of templates, faceplates, and other objects created to suit the needs of Northern Wasco County PUD.